Good morning, dear listeners, and welcome to Apex One Radio. The program on air is Apex Snapshot, and stay tuned. Exactly 8 a.m. by our studio clock here in Columbus, Ohio, in the United States of America. And it should be 1 p.m. there in Cameroon. The program on air right now is Apex Snapshot. Someone once said, a film is never really good unless the camera is an eye in the head of a poet. Movie making has been around for a while, and while others have ventured into thinking it was a leisure thing and given up, a lot have spent time, money, and a lot more to make sure they keep doing better in this seventh art profession. Today on Apex Snapshot, we will be talking to the cast and crew of a movie which has already gotten people raising eyebrows. Ken Shelley Monette is a producer and movie actor par excellence, and in about a bit, we will be listening to him alongside some members of the Victimized crew and cast. Stay tuned, people, and welcome to Apex One Radio.
I've been searching, 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 searching. I just wanna be happy, 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 happy. I already know where it stays. But how do I get it whenever I will? I used to know this feeling long ago.
Get There, and it's sung by Dark Ninja, a beautiful Cameroonian artist.
people, it's Dr. Nkeng Stephens. We just finished the shooting. Get there video by Daphne. I directed this video, I produced the song, so it's going to be.
Discuss no separate to my mind. I feel it in my heart. We share it. La distance no separate, but know that je t'aime si fort. N'attendi wa baby. Je t'aime si fort. Na ligio. Je t'aime si fort. N'attendi wa baby. Je t'aime si fort. Na ligio. Je suis là, mon bébé. Je serai là pour toi.
Welcome back, dear listeners of Apex One Radio. If you're just tuning in, then the program on air is Apex Snapshot, and it's exactly 8 minutes past 8 here in our studios in Columbus, Ohio. And the program on air once more is Apex Snapshot. Before we went on the short musical break, we were talking about the movie Victimized, and I promise you it's going to be a fun show today. And right now we are heading to Minnesota to talk to the producer of this much talked about movie. And he's going to tell us a lot more than I can tell you, because obviously he's the producer, right? Hello,
I'm right here.
Okay, Ken, welcome on board.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you for the time.
Oh, you're welcome. How is it today in Minnesota?
Well, so far, not too bad. You know, as usual, our weather is getting, you know, a little bit colder because, I mean, we live in a very cold place, but everything is so good. Temperature today should be about 65, but so far, everything is good.
Okay, I'm so happy to hear that. Yeah. So, could you briefly describe... Could you briefly tell us who Ken is? Like, tell us a little bit about yourself. Everybody just knows about Ken Charlie Monnet, and we want to hear about Ken Charlie Monnet from himself.
Well, Ken Charlie Monnet, like you rightly say, I'm a movie producer. I'm a script writer, and I'm also an actor. So, my experience in movie goes way back. Back in Cameroon from my days in primary school right up to secondary school. And when I relocated to the United States of America, I decided to continue in the art. And today I've produced my second movie. My very first movie was produced by Zontag Productions, The Storm.
Okay.
And today I've produced my second movie, Victimized, which I'm getting ready to air on, to premiere on September 10 here in Minnesota. And
wow.
So that's my second production, and then from there I'm getting ready to shoot my third movie titled Cul-de-sac.
Okay. we look forward to hearing and talking about that movie, but for today let's talk Victimized. So can you please tell us a bit about your family background?
Well, Kelshawn Monet is married. I have 2 kids. Okay. My daughter Nikki is 16, and my son Ken Darrow is 11. Yeah, and my wife is a nurse. So we all live in the U.S. and very happy family.
Wow.
And we do our best to keep the family in, you know, in good spirit and in good hope and trusting God for everything that we do.
Okay, as you earlier said, you grew up in Cameroon. So, what's the best experience you had in Cameroon?
Well, I mean, my best experience I had in Cameroon, it goes back to every day, my day-to-day life and everything, growing up with my friends and family when I was a kid, and then up to secondary school, where I went to PH Skumba, and I did my 7 years of education in PH Skumba. And today, I was able to, you know, I mean, it was a very good experience. Went to University of Yaoundé. I first went to Ahmadu Bello University of Zaria, but due to the political and Christian upheaval in Christians and Muslim conflict in that area, I decided to come back to Cameroon and completed my studies. And I have a bachelor's in Negro African literature.
Wow.
Then moved over to United States of America, and I have a master's degree in business administration. I have an MBA, and I specialize in project management.
Wow, that's so inspiring. And to think that you put all of that in a movie, that's a lot. Thank you very much, Ken Shirley Monet. And if you're just tuning in, no, you're tuned to Apex One Radio, and we are reporting live from Columbus, Ohio, in the United States of America. The program on air is Apex Snapshot, and today we're talking about the movie Victimized, which is set to be launched in Minnesota this September. So if you haven't gotten your ticket, then you should make sure to do so. So, Ken, as we ride on, would you want to tell us a bit more about your career as an actor? Like, when did it start exactly, and what has been your experience so far as an actor and coming to the United States?
Well, I would say that it goes back again when I was a kid. Like, during the time when I was in primary school, we used to do school plays, and we'll go in competitions like during 11 February and 20 May, National Days in Cameroon, and we'll do some performances. I was really very good during that time, and most of my teachers, they liked my acting, and I could play mostly the lead roles during the primary school days. And then from there, I moved over to secondary school when I was like in Form 1 up to Form 3. I would play like mostly being a chinda in a traditional play, or being, you know, just being a little kid in a play. And my teachers, they could see that skills and talent in me, and it started developing. And just when I got to Form 4, I started playing lead role in most of the plays. One of the greatest plays that I did, we played a very beautiful story, a very beautiful drama, titled This Is Our Chance by Anna Shin Hall. It was a very beautiful one, and I played the role of Chief Damba there. Yeah. And then after my secondary school days, and when I graduated from the university, alongside with one great writer and producer also, in person of Mr. Augustine Teche, who is of late today, we created a group called the Dynamic Youth Theater. And what we were doing during this time is that we'll go from school to school and perform school plays. And one of the greatest plays that we did that landed us a lot of popularity back home during that time was Olarotimi's The Gods Are Not to Blame, where I played the role of Odewale, the king. And we'll go to schools, you know, play this, do these plays, and recite poetry, lecture the students. As a matter of fact, during one of the years that we went down to some of the schools, especially a school like St. Joseph College of Sase, they were extremely impressed, because a lot of students said just from that hall, they were able to go to the GCE and write, and they passed because of what we did, the elaborated, you know, the excellent presentation that we did with those plays and those poems. And that year, I think Sase scored 100% in literature. So that's how we used to go from one town to the other doing this place. And if I take you back a little bit to my secondary school days, this talent was well developed in me by late Bate Bisong, because he was my teacher during my secondary school days. And when he found how good I was, he encouraged me more to get into literature. That's why I finally ended up with a bachelor's degree in Negro African Literature, University of Yaoundé. Wow. And I also, during my time there, I I met another great professor, Dr. Noor Alembong. He also found how smart I was in terms of that, and he encouraged me a lot, and he was extremely overwhelmed when he attended one of our ex-students association, and the play that was written to be in that ex-student association was by me, which I finally developed to The Storm, because during that time it was just a stage play for about 1 hour. Then I came back and I finally developed the story when I moved over to the U.S., okay. And that is what produced The Storm. Then from there, I got inspired with my to keep on writing because it's my passion. And it will shock a lot of people to know that it's the death of Michael Jackson that inspired me to write Victimized. I got inspired by following the death of Michael Jackson. Then again, a lot of people are asked, how did it inspire you? And I told them, the only way you can know that is by coming and watching the movie. Then you know how that the passing of Michael Jackson inspired me to write Victimized.
Okay, like so far you have been talking more about stage play, and to the best of my knowledge, stage play and movie making is not the same. Like, at what point did you exactly, you know, move from stage play to movie making?
Well, when I relocated over to the USA, because during the time when I was in Cameroon, the Cameroon film industry at that time was not really that effective as it is today. So when I moved over to United States of America 13 years ago, then I kept on writing, and during that time, the Cameroon film industry started growing up. And fortunately for me, I came across very, very great guys over here in the U.S. And you know, today, a lot of us have gone differently, doing things differently. But if I want to give credit for my success as an actor in the United States of America and as my success today as an actor, I will have to give that credit to people like Taco Abraham of Camwood, Erin Tang of Tollywood, and Akin McCauley. You know, these are the people that when I moved over to the U.S. and I came across them, I started working. One of the very first persons I started working with was Taco Abraham. And, you know, we had a very, very good relationship. And by then, he was producing movies. I think one of his first movies is Ready, Start, Nurse. I didn't play in that movie, but you know, I met with him, we talked, and I could see what he was trying to do. But we played a couple of movies that have not released yet and soon to be released. I did about 3 movies with him. Then I went ahead and I did 1 movie with Erin Tang that we were still to complete, you know. But he was a very great guy. And I was very impressed because they set the pace for me to be an actor in the U.S.
Yeah.
They told me exactly what the industry is and what should be my expectations and what they expect of me as an actor who is coming up. And to be candid, their advice to me, it helped me a lot because I put everything in place. And then again, luckily enough, I came across one great movie director, Akin McCauley, who was very, very abreast with the Cameroon film industry at that time. And we talked a lot, and he told me a lot about going about as an actor. And he was supposed to direct my very first movie, The Storm. But unfortunately, when Sontag Productions took over the movie, they hired a different director to continue with the production. But again, he was a very great inspiration to me. And I definitely give them credit for inspiring me and making me to grow. But I then also, in the course of all that, I did a movie with him, and forgotten the title of that movie. It's a movie that Akin directed back in Maryland, and we played alongside some characters like some popular names in the African film industry.
Okay.
John Dumelo and Van Vika. And then then from there, last year we shot another beautiful Cameroonian movie that was produced by the delectable Tiana Bibish, titled Swap. We shot that in Los Angeles, and it was directed by Aki Macaulay. That is another beautiful movie that is coming out soon, and I played the lead character in that movie. So I've had a very good experience. I also had a very good experience with another great Cameroonian director like Chael Gordon. So it's been a very great experience, and it's a good ride. And so far from there, I'm building myself and trying to take myself to where I know that I have to be, in as much as the industry is concerned.
Okay. Ken Shirley Monnet, before we take another musical break, just this last question. Are you considering going back to stage acting, given that your days in stage acting had much an influence, not just on yourself, but on the people, on the audience you are trying to reach? So do you think you are able to go back to stage acting or do it side-by-side movies?
Well, I mean, like they say, an actor never gets old, or, you know, you never lose track in the business. But stage playing right now would be a little bit difficult to go back, because I think that during the time when I was doing stage play in Cameroon, it was kind of a pace setter for me to develop my skills, talent and knowledge as an actor. So I can definitely, I mean, if I go back on stage play, I will still do very well. But it's not something that I'm looking at again right now, because I've developed myself right now to be more of a movie actor.
Okay.
than limiting myself to being a stage player. And my skills and knowledge and talent in acting now, like an actor, movie actor, has far surpassed my ability and skills as a stage player. So mostly now I'm more into acting as an actor in movies than doing stage play.
Okay, thank you very much, Ken Shirley Monnet. I will obviously get back to you because you are the man of the day. For now, we will just take a short musical break. Stay tuned. If you're just tuned in, know you're tuned to Apex One Radio, and the program on air is Apex Snapshot.
Come on, baby, we just feel like, come on, baby, just serait là pour toi, pour toi. Oui, baby, la distance nous sépare, c'est maman. Feel it in my heart. Oui, chérie, la distance nous sépare, but know that je t'aime si fort, n'attendis pas, baby. Je t'aime si fort, n'allégio. Je t'aime si fort, n'attendis pas, baby. Je t'aime si fort, n'allégio. Oh, baby, oui, je suis. Hear what people say, they will bring us down. We don't listen to them now. Troubles will come, but we will stay strong. We, je t'aime si fort, n'attendis pas, baby. Je t'aime si fort, n'allégui yo. Je t'aime si fort, n'attendis pas, baby. Je t'aime si fort, n'allégui yo.
Bam, bam, hey. Hey, lovers of education and promoters of development. It's another school year and back to school period. So, what kind of education do you want for your child? Quality education, of course. By quality education, we mean a lot of things, including well-equipped and functioning libraries, science laboratories, multimedia centers, and the list continues. These and more are the facilities which the USA branch of the Government Bilingual High School Fontem X Students Association seek to improve upon for their alma mater. A fundraising convention to that effect has been slated for the city of Columbus, Ohio, on Saturday, September the 3rd, 2016. Come and be part of this noble project at Days in North Columbus, 1212 East Dublin, Granville, Ohio, 43231. Again, Days in North Columbus, 1212 East Dublin, Granville, Ohio, 43231. The event begins at 8 p.m. prompt. For more information, call 978-766-1816 or 614-226-8864 or 614-282-8164 or better still, 614-818-0685. The GBHS Fontem X Students Association, molding tomorrow's leaders by promoting quality education.
Program on air is Apex Snapshot. It's exactly 8:30 by our studio clock, and that is 1:30 p.m. there in Cameroon and Europe. If you're just tuning in, then you know we are talking about the movie Victimized on today's edition of your favorite program here on Apex One Radio. And we're broadcasting live from Columbus, Ohio in the United States of America. Today is 27th day of August 2016. Before we went on the short musical break, we had been talking to producer and director Ken Charlie Monet, and he has been telling us a lot about himself and about this program, the movie Victimized. Yeah, we also have Clara Fernando, who happens to be an actress in this movie, and she will be talking to us all the way from Maryland, and she'll be telling us all about her experience on this movie, Victimized. Stay tuned and listen to Clara. Hello, Clara. Hello. Hello, Clara.
Hello.
Yeah, welcome to Apex One Radio.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, how are you doing today?
I'm doing well. Thank you. How are you?
I'm fine. So, how is Maryland today? Oh, you said you just got in. So, how was your flight?
Well, it's beautiful. It's hot. Actually, I'm in North Carolina.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. Okay, so how's North Carolina today?
North Carolina is great. Not too hot, maybe because it's too early, but I don't know. Probably will get hot, but right now it's good.
Okay. So let's talk Victimized. How was it working on the set of Victimized?
Well, working on set of Victimized was great. I mean, every time you get on set, it's like you form a family, you get to meet different people. So it was great. You know, it's like you just adopted a new family. I loved working with the crew and in the cast and crew. It was great.
Okay. So, was there any particular thing that that drew your attention that really caused you to want to do this movie?
I mean, when I received the script, it was just different. You know, like, most of the time we, like, know where the movie's gonna end. We know how, we already know the conclusion of the movie. But when you watch Victimized, he has a whole lot of, a lot of twist to it. It's a very great story, and it teaches a lot. So it's not just about you watching the movie. It's about you learning some things from the movie. I mean, what caught me was the script. The script was really great, well written, and I'm like, this is something that I want to be part of.
Okay.
So, yes.
That sounds really interesting. I mean, I would want to rush and get my ticket for the premiere right now.
Yes, you should. Don't miss out.
Yeah. So, what character do you play in this movie, and did you enjoy doing it?
Well, I enjoyed playing the role of being an evil sister, actually. I was the evil sister in the movie, and I mean, it's a whole different story being evil to someone that has not done something to you, and being evil to someone that has actually offended you, and it works in the favors of God. Like, you know, it just shows you that having a bad heart to people is not something that is appropriate in life, or that something has to happen to different people. We were just like evil to our sister in the movie, and she actually didn't do anything. But hey, that's part of life. We all learn about different things in life. Well, that's why people need to watch the movie and see for themselves.
Okay. And what was most challenging about this movie to you?
The challenging part was stabbing someone. That was really challenging, you know.
Yeah.
I was really, really I was scared. I mean, even though you're an actress, there's certain roles that are just so challenging. That was probably my most, and I mean, stabbing and lying and just laughing people. I mean, but stabbing was probably one of the most challenging parts.
Okay. What do you think makes the movie a must-watch, apart from all what you just said? What do you really think makes this movie stand out from any other movie that you've acted or watched before?
I mean, what's different to this movie is the way the script was written. You know, this movie is like a family movie. So you can have your kids watch this movie with you. It's all about a learning experience, about, you know, things happen in life, but we all have to learn through it. So Victimized has a lot of twist to it, like I said before, and it will keep you glued to the TV, because when you have a scene, you never know how the movie is going to end. But all I'm going to say is it's a must watch, and it's an all great learning experience. And all the parents out there shouldn't even be scared watching this movie with their kids, because it's great.
Okay. Dear listeners of Apex One Radio, if you're just tuned in, then you're tuned to our program Apex Snapshot, and we are reporting live from Columbus, Ohio. Today it is 27th day of August 2016. The program on air is Apex Snapshot, and today on Apex Snapshot, we are talking about the movie Victimized. We have spoken to Ken Charlie Monad, who will still be coming up in a bit, and right now we are talking to Clara Fernando, the beautiful Clara Fernando. I mean, guys, if you would want to go to this premiere, don't just go to see this movie. Go to watch these beautiful actors and actresses who have put in their all into this work. It will be a beautiful experience, people. Yeah, and back to you, Clara Fernando. So, what can you say about the cast and crew of this movie, apart from they just being nice? What can you say about them?
I mean, they all brought in different energies. You know, like, when you are shooting a movie, you all get stressed at some point. But they were all very encouraging and very supportive. We all were just like a family, and that's what I loved about the cast and crew for this movie. It was all about the passion and, you know, and just uplifting each other and just be there for one another and say, this is for ours. This is for us. We can do this.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm done.
Oh, yeah. And how different is it? The movie Victimized, or the set of Victimized, how different was it from any other movie you had done before, given that you have been in it for a while?
Okay. What was different about this movie compared to, I shot probably two movies prior to this one. What was different about this movie is how everything was just like transitioning to what you call reality. Like, you saw so much emotion and so much passion. It's like everybody was into it. So that's something that I saw, that, okay, people, this is not really acting. This is really reality. Like, people were like, yeah, people are, like, so into it. You know how, like, some other movies just doing it for the heck of it.
Yeah.
Because it's a movie and it's a script is there. But this was different. It's like, it was like everybody was just, like, you know, trying to get this done. Like, okay, this is for us. This is our movie. This is what we want the world to see this. We want the world to learn about it. And that's what I noticed that was different about this movie.
Okay, that's really, really beautiful. Ahead of the September 10th premiere, how do you feel? Are you anxious, or you're just like chilling and waiting for it?
I'm excited, actually. I'm very, very excited, because we all gonna watch that movie together, because I have not even seen the movie myself.
Wow.
So we all gonna experience this together. So I'm really excited, and, you know, I can't wait.
Okay, that's really, it's really, I know how it feels. I love what you explain. I get you, girl. So do you want to give a shout out to any people as we draw close to the end of your part of this interview?
Man, I just want to give a shout out to, shout out to God first. He's the one who made that movie happen, gave everybody the energy. And I just want to give a shout out to the cast and crew. I mean, job well done. And I'm grateful to be on the line on Apex Radio.
Oh, thank you, Clara Fernando. It's been a very beautiful time talking to you. And I hope we're going to have you here once more and keep us posted on whatever you're doing. And Apex One Radio will always be there to support you. We support entertainment, we support innovation, and we support anything that gives a positive impact to people out there. So thank you, Clara Fernando, and we hope to talk to you once more. Dear listeners, that was Clara Fernando, an actress in the movie Victimized, and we were talking to her all the way from North Carolina, and she has been so interesting so far, and it's really hard to see someone beautiful in and out. I mean, you should see that girl. Just rush, get your ticket, and run over to Minnesota on September 10th, and you'll get to behold all these beautiful personalities, take pictures on the red carpet, and not only that, you'll get to watch this movie, Victimized, which has got a lot of people talking, and hope you learn something from it, as the director said. Away from that, for now, we'll take a short musical break, and when we come back, we'll be talking to Ken Charlie Monette, the writer and producer of this wonderful, much talked about movie. Stay tuned, people. This is Apex One Radio, baby.
Kinga, Kinga, Kinga. Je connais des hommes qui sont prêts à tout donner pour avoir une femme qui les aime. Oh oui, je connais aussi des hommes qui ont des femmes qui les aiment, mais qui sont incapables de reconnaître cet amour même. La femme, c'est ton plus beau cadeau.
Cette chanson est titrée Ma femme, et se chantée par Dynasty Le Tigre et Stanley Eno. Ce sont deux artistes très, 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 très polyvalents venant du Cameroun.
Si tu ne peux pas prendre soin d'elle, quelqu'un d'autre le fera à ta place et tu verras. Je trouve ça tragique de voir un mec dans la rue qui brutalise sa femme parce qu'ils ont les petits problèmes. Comment peux-tu taper ton amour? C'est le roi qui fait battre ton cœur. Les femmes sont nos bébés, il faut les cajoler, oui. Les femmes sont nos bébés, il faut les cajoler, oui, oui. Elles ont besoin d'affection, elles n'ont pas besoin d'être brutalisées. Papa dynastie, la femme, c'est ton plus beau cadeau. Si tu ne peux pas prendre soin d'elle, quelqu'un d'autre le fera à ta place et tu verras. Ta femme, c'est ton plus beau cadeau. Si tu ne peux pas prendre soin d'elle, quelqu'un d'autre le fera à ta place et tu verras. Eke aminga, manyame teme kanaya. Bulwa kun kanane sasama bote ya ne mote mienne. Mono gonde la telmo sumo me telmo me roña. Anaya ye tenjimin ento ma puento ma nyunga.
kaya minga menyame temu kana ya kuluba kun kana neza sama bota ya ne mota ya ne mono gonde la temu suma mata na mamalonya ana ya ya dimine bua ba 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 to ma yule
moi j'aime ma go moi j'aime ma go moi j'aime ma go
moi j'aime ma go
chérie moi j'aime ma go ma guéri béton la femme c'est ton plus beau cadeau. Si tu ne peux pas prendre soin d'elle, quelqu'un d'autre le fera à ta place. Et tu verras, la femme c'est ton plus beau cadeau. Si tu ne peux pas prendre soin d'elle, quelqu'un d'autre le fera à ta place. Et tu verras.
They say love is a beautiful thing, but you know every beautiful thing needs pain. No pain, no gain, that's the rule of the game. Better ready up your mind, cause you know all or not be played. God damn, 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 she don't want your beautiful ring, ring. Brother, better be real, real. Love her under the rain.
He is called the King Kong. Stanley,
you know. Yeah, yeah, yeah. When love is gone, she ducks and she don't tire. You can ask my nigga, then I see the tiger. You know me, well, you know my name, not Stanley. And I wait until my man, young King Kong. This is for my queen.
La femme, c'est ton plus beau cadeau. Si tu ne peux pas prendre soin d'elle, quelqu'un d'autre le fera à ta place. Et tu verras. La femme, c'est ton plus beau cadeau.
Welcome welcome back to Apex One Radio. If you're just tuning in, the program on air is Apex Snapshot. And we are reporting live from Columbus, Ohio today, this 27th day of August 2016. The time by our studio clock is exactly 8:51 and it's 1:51 over there in Cameroon. Before we went on a short musical break, we were talking to Clara Fernando, who is an actress in the movie Victimized. And before her, we have had Ken Charlie Monette, who is a producer and director of this same movie. Right now, we are going right back to Minnesota to continue talking to Ken Charlie Monette, and he will be talking to us. He will be throwing more light on what the movie Victimized and its concept is all about. Stay tuned, people, and keep listening to Apex One Radio. Hello, Ken.
Hello. Yes, I'm right here.
Okay, Ken. It's nice to have you back.
Thank you.
Okay, so what's the weather in Minnesota like at this particular point?
Well, again, like I said, a little bit cold, but it's very common with Minnesota. But right now, temperature should be about 55. But today, I know we're gearing up towards the 60s and 70s in the course of the day. So weather is still very good, very nice weather to be in bed, but definitely I'm up right now because I'm supposed to be on the air.
Okay. So, talking about Victimized, you wrote and produced this movie. So, you already said you got your inspiration from Michael Jackson's Death, but when did you actually start writing the movie? Like, at what point did you feel like, okay, this thing has got to be written somewhere?
Again, like I said, you know, when I started writing this movie, immediately, I mean, Michael Jackson is one of the greatest artists that I really do admire. And I mean, almost everybody admires him worldwide. When he passed away, I was very, very prone to his case, and I followed every bit of information from the first day that he passed away until the day that they were following up the case and interviewing whosoever were involved and what happened with his dad and how he passed away. So I was extremely keen to that. Sometimes I'll even take off work just to follow up that case on the TV. That's how much I loved him as an artist. And in the course of the interview and what really transpired during the death of Michael Jackson, then I got that trigger. There was a piece of information that I got from his passing away that triggered something in my mind. And after following that discourse and taking down some notes, I sat back again and read the notes, and I got that same piece of information from the notes. And then it just, you know, it just opened up something in my brain. I'm like, okay, with what I got, I can be able to come up with a story. You know, and yeah, that is how I got inspired. And then from there, I just sat down, I picked up my pen, because most of the time my scripts, you know, I do my scripts mostly in the traditional way. I write them, I handwrite my stories before I type them on computer, because when I handwrite my stories, my imagination flows better. So I sat down and started writing the story, and I was just, you know, writing the story, going from one scene to the other, and I could see how the pieces were falling together. And then I finally came up with this beautiful story, Victimized. And you know, I had a lot of different working titles for the movie, and I had close to about 8 working titles for the movie, but I finally settled up with the title Victimized. And so, like I said, a few people have quizzed me on how did the passing of Michael Jackson inspired me to write this movie. But again, I told them that answer they will only get on September 10th when they come in to watch Victimized, because that is when they will know how I got inspired by the death of Michael Jackson to come up with a story like Victimized.
Okay. So how long did it take you to complete the script?
Usually it's not the moment I get the story. It doesn't really take me too long to write it out. I'm a very, very fast and writer because it's something I've been doing for long. I know all the techniques of writing. So Victimized is a story. Normally, it's a movie that's supposed to run for about 4 hours, but I streamlined it down to not to make it that long. But again, Victimized, a story of that sort would take a lot of people a long time, but it took me just about 2 weeks, and I came up with the story of Victimized. Because again, like I said, I had prepared myself a lot. I had followed up his interview. And then in the course of creating the story, I put down the point that I need to develop the story. And when I went into writing, it didn't really take me that long. Within 2 weeks, I had a full script. And then I got it, you know, typed everything down there. And then, you know, had the story together. Yeah.
Okay. Can you tell us a bit, like give us a little bit, like who is Victimized in the story Victimized?
It's just like talking to Clara. When you talk to Clara, she played the role of Ashley, so I'll call her Ashley.
Mm-hmm.
You know, talking to her, and there is one thing that she said to you, that the twist, there's a twist.
Yeah.
A very big twist in the movie, and you know, one of the things that I was very impressed about the story, because after coming up with the story, you know, and giving it to actors and actresses, you want to get their feedbacks. And I was impressed with one thing, because almost every actor that read the script, there is one message that they gave me, that I succeeded in getting them completely lost with their expectations, because they had a specific expectation why they were reading the story.
Wow.
It was something that they knew that they were going to get there, that, and that is how they knew it was going to be a story. But when they kept on reading, and when they were getting into the middle and towards the end of the story, they realized that they were totally derailed. I threw them off completely, and that is how Victimized is. It's extremely a very big twist, and I, from their impression that they gave me, then I know for sure, judging from what they're saying, that every single person who is going to sit down and watch Victimized entirely, I have the impression that they will also have the same feelings like my cast had during the time that they were going through the script.
Wow.
To play their role in Victimized.
That's a huge achievement as a writer. Like, if you can even thrill even your actors, then it must really be something. So what particular message do you intend to pass across in this story, and who are your target audience?
Well, definitely, I mean one of the good things is that when you are a script writer, when you are an actor going on set, you should be able to make sure that the story that you write, it has an impact on people. It, you know, it kind of like change people's life and give them a different view on how they were seeing certain things, and help them to change and, you know, get a better way of viewing things and doing things and reacting towards things. And one of the main thing is that the story is out definitely to pass a message. And the question again, like you said, what message that this story is passing? Again, people will get that message when it comes September 10th.
Oh my God, Ken, you can't do this to us. Like, you keep hyping the suspense after every question. Okay, right,
yeah.
Now I wish you could just have it tomorrow, so I just come and get all my answers and go to sleep. What do you mean?
There you go.
Okay, so if you're just tuning in, then the program on air is Apex Snapshot, and we are reporting live from Columbus, Ohio. The time by our studio clock is exactly 9 a.m. And at this point, we are going to take a short musical break, and we'll be right back, people. Stay tuned. This is Apex One Radio, baby.
Hey, lovers of education and promoters of development. It's another school year and back to school period. So, what kind of education do you want for your child? Quality education, of course. By quality education, we mean a lot of things, including well-equipped and functioning libraries, science laboratories, multimedia centers, and the list continues. These and more are the facilities which the USA branch of the Government Bilingual High School Fontaine Ex Students Association seek to improve upon for their alma mater. A fundraising convention to that effect has been slated for the city of Columbus, Ohio, on Saturday, September the 3rd, 2016. Come and be part of this noble project at Days in North Columbus, 1212 East Dublin, Granville, Ohio, 43231. Again, Days in North Columbus, 1212 East Dublin, Granville, Ohio, 43231. The event begins at 8 p.m. prompt. For more information, call 978-766-1816 or 614-226-8864 or 614-282-8164 or better still, 614-818-0685. The GBHS Fontaine X Students Association, molding tomorrow's leaders by promoting quality education.
Designer, yeah, yeah, I'm a designer for my body.
listeners, and welcome back on air. This is Apex One Radio, and we're broadcasting live from Columbus, Ohio. The time by our studio clock is 6 minutes past 9, and it's exactly 2 p.m. there in Cameroon. Hello to all our listeners from Cameroon. And the program on air is Apex Snapshot. And so far, it's been wonderful. We've been talking to the cast and crew of the movie Victimized. And right now, we are going right back to Minnesota to continue talking to actor, director, writer, you can name the rest, Ken Charlie Monette. Hello, Ken.
Hello, I'm right here.
It's nice having you back.
Thank you.
Okay, so before we went on the short musical break, we had been talking a lot about Victimized. If you just tuned in, I'm sorry, you missed a lot. So, could you quickly present to us the cast and crew of this movie?
Okay, I would definitely do that. But just a point of correction, Ken Charlie Monette is not a movie director. Oh. I've not gone into that yet, so I just asked and produce and write, so...
Okay.
But I'm not directing yet. I think I still need to learn that.
Okay, anyway. Thanks for that correction, Ken. So, over to you.
Anyway, Victimized is one of the things I like about the movie is that it has an entirely very large cast and crew. And the good thing about it is that it's extremely diverse because we went, all over entire Africa and the world and get the right people to fit in for this story. It's the cast and crew is extremely large because it's a very large movie. Going to the cast, going to the crew of the movie first. Like you all know, the director of the movie is Ephraim G. Ejina Onyemechi. And Ephraim, a little bit about him is, Ephraim happens to be a very good director, and he's from Nigeria. And he's played movie with very, very, those when you call them the A-list actors in the African movie production today. He's played movies with these A-list actors and actresses. And he goes back way during his time back in Nigeria. And he did a lot of productions and a lot of movies with them. And when I contacted him to be the director for Victimized, just from talking with him, then I knew that, okay, I was talking to the right person. And I think it just gives people that time, September 10, to come and see what this guy can really do as a movie director. Then continuing down on the cast, on the crew again, the cameraman was our own popular Christopher Okwongwo. He's one of the greatest cameramen who has been producing our movies over here in the U.S. And his knowledge with the camera is extremely good. And the shots that he took during the shooting of Victimized is just for people to come and see.
Wow.
Then the editor of the movie happens to be a very good friend of mine that we played one of his movies together. The movie, titled Menage, that was shot here in Minnesota. And I played the role of a bad guy, and he's a very, very great editor. He graduated from New York School of Academy as an editor, and when he saw Victimized, that's the one thing about him is that this is a guy, one of the things about him is that, according to him, he doesn't put his name on anything if it doesn't worth him putting his name on it. But when I gave him the images of Victimized and he read the script, the story of Victimized, he told me he was going to edit Victimized no matter what. And he said, even if it happens that I'm not going to pay him to edit this movie, he's very ready to do it for free because he could see the worth of the story and Victimized. It's worth putting his name on it.
Wow.
And he did everything and put the images together. And I bet you a very, very beautiful image. You can see from the trailer. The sound. I mean, he did an awesome, an excellent job editing Victimized. He put Victimized into an A class. He put Victimized to the level that it is worth the director's time. It is worth the cast time. It is what the crew time. It is what everything that we put together to make Victimized what it is. And I definitely praise him for that. Then continue again on the crew. We have the executive producers of the movie, which happens to be my wife, Pamela Ngamne, and another person who played in the movie, Mata Tungo.
Oh, okay.
And then continue again on that. Then the producer, of course, is myself.
Uh-huh.
And then going down to the cast of the movie, like I said, it's a very broad movie, and I may not be able to remember all the names of everybody, but I'll do as much I can. Going down to the cast of the movie, the main lead actor was played by myself, Ken Charlie Monet, and the lead actress was played by a beautiful lady from South Africa, Desiree Ay. And then the sub-lead actresses, you had Clara Fernando, who played Ashley. And then you have Seal Anim, who played Lisa Tazo. Then Desiree Ay played Lillian Monono. Then Ken Charlie Monet played Jones Senze. Then we had Michelle Gijo also. That's another very great Cameroonian actor. I met him on set for the first time, and when we met, and he came on set, when he took over that role, that important role, that role that carries Victimized, that is the role that carries this movie.
Wow.
The role that Michelle played in this movie. When he took over that role, I sat there and I watched him when he came on set. I saw him for the first time on set. Even the director, I could see the smile on his face. It's that smile of satisfaction that meeting this actor and seeing what he did on that movie, I could see the smile of satisfaction on his face. I mean, you just need to watch this movie to see what this guy did to interpret that role. Then we have the cast again going down. We have Micheline Ewang, who played in the movie. We have Sir Ryan, another great guy. He played in the movie. Then we have we have Anago, who played our FBI agent in the movie. You need to watch him also. And then we have Ayong Jose, who was also a lawyer in the movie. Then we have Stella Icon, who is also a producer. She just released one of her movies, A Message to Brian. She's from Nigeria. We have Paola Obaseki, who is also from Nigeria. She was a journalist in the movie. Then we have Micheline Ewang, who also played in the movie. We have Clark Brunson. I hope I pronounced his name right. He's a white guy. He was the main. He was a judge in the movie. Then we have another young, great actor, Flam Fees. Then I came across this wonderful couple, and they played the couple in the movie. The CEOs of Nagwa Boutique, Emma Talbot and Joe Ngwafa. I bet you, I cannot thank them enough for the success of this movie. They will definitely get to that part for me to be able to explain to you what they did for this movie to get to where it is today. So we had a very beautiful cast. We had a very beautiful crew, beautiful people, great minds. We all came together and put our minds together. And like Clara told you, when we were on that movie set, it was not even like we were doing a movie. It was everything that was translated to reality, because we put everything together, and it was more like a family bonding together and having fun and doing what they do well and doing it the right way. So it was a beautiful cast, beautiful people, and everything went great from the start of shooting till we called the last shot while in Maryland.
Okay, so usually we have this problem that when these movies are released, we don't even know where to find them. Like, not everybody is going to be at the premiere. And even if you attend the premiere, then you get to tell your neighbor about this beautiful movie, and then the neighbor will be like, where can I get it from? Then you are dumbfounded. You don't even know what to say, because that has been the fate of many movies that have been launched here, especially in the diaspora. How do you intend to market this movie, Ken Charlie Monet?
Yeah, that's another great question. Again, I'm still very open to marketing ideas. Any person who has some ideas on how we can market the movie, I'm extremely open to work with different people and work with different avenues of putting this movie out into the public, because I would definitely want the world to watch this movie and really get what the story of this movie is about. That notwithstanding, I'm going to do my best to make sure that this movie is out. So my intention was that I did not want to put the cart in front of the horse. That, what do I mean by that? What I'm just trying to say is, I've talked to a couple of people on marketing strategy, and a lot of people encouraged me to put the movie out as yet. But I said, no, I would not want to put the movie out until it is premiered. So my intention was to wait until I get this movie premiered, because from the premiere, and for those who are going to be there, I'm going to get a lot of feedbacks of what we did in the movie and if there is anything that we did wrong that need to be fixed before it is released. Because I don't want to put anything to the public that will not meet the standard of what we did for the movie. So I want to make sure that the actors and actresses and the cast and crew will sacrifice their time to come and shoot Victimized. When they see this movie, they should be impressed and proud about it. And that's the reason why it took me a long time to edit the movie, because the editor said he's going to take his time. And it took close to about 3 months to edit this movie, if you can imagine. He took his time. We were there. I would go sometimes and meet him in the studio. He would put one scene and stay back and take his time before he put the other scene. That's how much time he put into this production to make it get to the level and standard that it deserves. So presenting it to the public first and getting their impression will give me the go-ahead to present it to marketers, because I know that from there, when it goes to the marketers, then they will know that they have the right product. Again, after the premiere, I will look into the marketing strategy, and I'm extremely open with ideas on how we can market the movie, because I want the movie to spread as much as it can. So I'm extremely open to ideas. People can chip in on how we can market, which marketer we should contact, how we can contact them, and how we can get them to go ahead and start marketing the production. So I will exploit all the avenues of marketing up to the point of putting the movies into CDs so that people can watch them.
Okay, Ken Charlie Monet, you know, when you start talking business, I really don't know what to say. So let's go to what I'm excited about. Okay, the premiere. Ahead of the September 10th premiere, what have you put on ground to make sure everything goes as planned?
Well, so far, with the team that is managing the premiere, the conversation that is going so far is good. We already have a location. The premiere is going to take place here in Minnesota, 1020 Bandana Boulevard, West St. Paul, Minnesota. We have a location that is already set. We have screens that are ready to carry out the movie. We have close to about 8 screens that's going to be blasted in the hall, because it's a big hall. So the premiere is set up, and definitely to meet the standard of the movie and the standard and the class of the people who have already, you know, shown their interest in coming up for the premiere to watch this great movie. So everything is set up. We are still putting things in place, trying to, you know, dot all the I's and getting the T's, but everything is set up and Victimizes. I should say it's about 90% ready to go.
Wow. So who are the personalities that you would be expecting on the red carpet?
Oh, a lot of great personalities. For sure, I know that Carissa LaBelle is going to be there.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I know for sure that she's going to be there, and people would like to meet you and see this beautiful lady who is granting this great interview over the air. I know for sure that my Apex One radio team, they are very ready to go there, because normally, as I'm talking again right now,
always.
I speak double as resource person number one for Apex Radio. I know for sure that my great friend, though he is not based here, Phil Marshall, Valerie Dulafe, I know for sure he's going to be here in spirit. I know for sure that Ifeanyi Akwala, also all the way from Cameroon, and Marcel Banyo and Titus Banyo and Marcel Ading and Solomon, I mean the entire Apex Radio team, I know for sure that those who are not based in the U.S., they will be there in spirit.
Always and then representing.
Again, exactly. And then again, for the great personalities who are going to be there, Carl Payne is an American actor, and he happens to be very interested with African movies production. He's based in Houston. He has already told me he's going to be there. I can't wait to have him. That's one guy also who has inspired me a lot with my acting, because during the time when we were shooting Swap, we had some few scenes that we shot in Houston. And when he put me down and coached me before I went on set that day, I mean, he coached me once on how to carry out that scene. And when I went on there, when I did what he told me, you know, there was definitely, I mean, even the director could not even say that, okay, do it this way or that way. Everything was perfect, and I could see the smile on his face. Great actor. He's going to be there. Cameroonian actors and actresses is going to be presented by the beautiful and talented Tiana Bibish.
Wow.
People should come and see how talented she is, because I know for sure we are going to love you. I mean, I just saw a video that she posted talking like a grandmom on YouTube, on Facebook this morning, and I've been cracking myself here before tuning in for the show tonight. We have beautiful cast that is coming. The entire cast will be there. My actors and actresses, they have promised that they are going to be there, and it's going to be a very beautiful day. It's going to be a wonderful time. It will be an extremely great time, and I'm definitely extremely excited, and I'll be back again on air, Apex One Radio, to tell people the after premiere. So extremely excited.
Okay, so ticket cost, how much does it cost to get a seat on in that hall?
Well, I mean, to get a seat in the hall, regular tickets goes for $50 a piece. The VIP, we have the VIP table that can seat six people for $500, or one person can decide to buy a ticket for $100. Every ticket comes with a dinner. It's a dinner style class premiere. And again, red carpet pictures, a single picture a piece goes for about $10, and you know, fun time. And that is how it is. And after the movie presentation and after all the performances, also don't forget, we've been talking to this other great artist, Nelly, who's hopefully she's going to perform on that day. And then Micheline Ewang, who also doubles as a musician, and she played in the movie, and she also composed the sound that was used for Victimized. Yeah, she's going to be there, and you know, she's a very, 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 very extremely talented. You just have to listen to Micheline sing and listen to the beautiful sounds that she composed for Victimized. So, I mean, it's going to be a fun night. I also have Blessed Christian Stichet, who is also a great Cameroonian producer. He also said that he's going to be on there. So it will be a very, very great time. It will be a very beautiful time. I mean, just being around these beautiful people, taking ideas from them. We also have the Nagua Boutique CEOs who play the couple in the movie, Ima and Joe. They are going to be here. And I mean, I would just want people to come in, meet these beautiful people, talk with them, get ideas from them, and you know, see what they could do to put Victimized together to the level that it is. So beautiful people will be there, and it will be a fun night. After the movie, there will be party and dancing, and people will just have fun for the entire night until they get tired. It's dancing till you get tired. So whatever time you get tired on Sunday, if you want to leave at 1 p.m. or 2 p.m. on Sunday, that is fine with us.
Okay, as we draw close to the end of your interview, Ken Shirley Monet, I know, like, so far during this interview, we have had people listening, and if someone who aspires to be an actor has been listening to you, what would you tell the person?
I would just tell them, just keep it up. Follow your dream. Stay positive. communicate. Search for where there are those productions. Ask questions. Nobody ever knows too much. No matter how much I can be in this industry as an actor, I still do not know a lot. So every single day I learn, even from those who are aspiring to become actors, I'm learning from them. Because every time I come across them, whatever I teach them, they teach me one thing or something too, that I use it to go and change my, to improve on my talent. So the only thing I will tell them is that movie industry, a lot of people have some bad impression about movie industry. But I think if you come into the industry with the wrong set of mind, then you are going to misconceive or misquote the movie industry. But when you come with the right set of mind, then you are going to enjoy the industry. It's a very beautiful industry. It's especially when you have that time to meet with people that you have never met before, sitting together, staying together, bonding together, acting together, cooking together, eating together, sitting at one place, carrying out conversation. It's extremely beautiful. So all I would tell them is that they should continue to have that beautiful and positive mindset. And the most important thing that is for me is that the love for what you do is more important than what you are going to get from what you do. Because when you have that love and passion for what you do, whatever you want to achieve out of it is going to come.
Thank you, Ken Shale Monette. And just before we pull the curtains, can you tell us again the date, the venue, and the important context for anybody who would want to make it to this premiere?
Again, the day is September 10, 2016. The venue is 1020 Bandana Boulevard West, St. Paul in Minnesota. Time for red carpet, 6 p.m. at the dot. Red carpet runs from 6 until about 7:30, and dinner runs from 7:30 until about 8 p.m. And from 8:30, the movie starts. And after that, within that, we have performances that will go on, entertainment. And then after the movie, one or two words from some great people in the hall. And then we just go to dance, and have fun. Tickets, again, regular tickets goes for $50 a piece. VIP table, seat 6, it goes for $500. Or a single VIP ticket, it goes for $100. And everything comes with dinner. So let's come together. Let's party. Let's have fun. It's a fun field day, and I know we are going to have fun.
Oh, thank you very much, Ken Shale Monette. It's been a great pleasure having you around, and it's been a fun day today. And I wish you well. I wish you the best as you prepare for this upcoming premiere, and keep us posted about anything that you are doing. Anyways, you are part of us, so we'd always know anyways, even if you don't tell us. Have a wonderful day, Ken, and my regards to everybody there in Minnesota, and a special shout out to anyone listening to us all the way from there. And yeah, it's been Apex Snapshot, and we have been talking about the premiere of Victimized, a movie which was written and produced by Ken Shale Monette and directed by FM Chiejina, which for some technical reasons he could not get to us today, but it would have been a great pleasure talking to him. A special shout out to him and the entire cast and crew of this wonderful movie, Victimized. With that, we have come to the end of this live edition of Apex Snapshot. Special thanks to our listeners in the Minnesota, Maryland, Connecticut, and Cameroon. This show was monitored by entire Apex One radio team, produced by Marcel Adick from Europe, and supervised by Ines Kenjo. I've been Carista LaBelle at the central microphone, asking you to join us again next week for another edition of Apex Snapshot. Until then, it's bye-bye for now, and stay blessed, people. This is Apex One radio, baby.
Good day.
Quoi ça? Mais c'est quelle histoire ça?
Ouais.
Magete gentle mndaga kama be satisfied malogete dashi kimndaga even if I get for fight mama fungin' kid.